Dear students, welcome to online classes. Today we are going to discuss about the lesson Metals and Non-Metals from 8th class Physics. So let us have some pictures here and try to name the metals from which the objects are made. Most of these materials are made from metals. And we need to know the term clearly, the metals. So we are very familiar with aluminium, silver, lead, iron, copper, tin, mercury, etc. So the mercury is used in thermometers. Aluminium is used as a metal mesh or protection for windows. And silver metal is used in the making of idols, and lead is used in the decoration and shoulderings, and copper is used in our daily life. Mostly the materials are divided into two types. They are metals and non-metals. So let us differentiate the metals and non-metals by checking their properties. First, physical properties. In that, the first one is appearance. So the materials which have a bright surface and reflect light are called lustrous in nature, and materials that do not shine are called non-lustrous materials. Let us see here, the gold biscuits are there which have a very shiny surface. Hence, gold is an example for lustrous material. For this, let us do activity 1 by observing the appearance and color of some materials. So we have taken some materials. Let us check by seeing only whether they are shiny surface or not. So we have here 4 types of substances, materials. First one is iron bars, copper rods, zinc rods, and sulfur, and check the appearance whether their surface is shining or not. And then we have 4 more samples: aluminium, carbon, magnesium, and iodine. Let us check the surfaces whether they are shining or not. From this we can make a table which has a shiny surface and which doesn't have a shiny surface along with their colors. And from our observations we conclude that the samples iron, zinc, copper, aluminium, magnesium and iodine are shiny in nature, and sulfur, carbon are not shining in nature. Coming to the colors, they have different colors. Conclusion from the activity is, in general, metals are lustrous in nature. There are some exceptions. Even iodine is a non-metal, but it has a shiny surface. So now, do all we say that metals are lustrous in nature? Do all lustrous materials are metals? No, the reverse question is wrong, because mirrors are shiny in nature, but they are not metals. So we need to look at several properties to decide if a given material is a metal or not. Second property is sonority. To understand this clearly, let us do activity 2, which has a listening the sound produced by some material. Take the pieces of iron, zinc, copper, aluminium, magnesium and tightly packed packets of sulfur, carbon and iodine. Let us check only few here. Drop them one by one on a hard surface. Listen carefully to the sound produced by the materials and record your observations in the table. From the above experiment, we can observe that some of the materials are making some ringing sound and some are not making ringing sound. The observations are like this. Iron, zinc, copper and aluminium make ringing sound when they drop on the ground, and sulfur, carbon, iodine, magnesium, these do not produce ringing sound. From this, we can say that some may produce sound and some may not produce sound. Conclusion: materials which produce ringing sound are called sonorous materials, and the materials which do not are called non-sonorous materials. By observing this activity, most of the metals are sonorous in nature. The materials other than metals are not sonorous. Luster and sonority are the properties associated with the metals, but there is no need that all the metals should possess the both properties. Example: mercury. Mercury is the only metal which is in liquid state. Even though it has a shiny surface, it doesn't have sonorous property.